In Genesis chapter 1, verse 27, this is what it says. So God created man, it's mankind, people like you and me, in his own image. Theologians call this the Imago Dei. If anyone ever asks you, do you know what the Imago Dei is? You can say, yeah, and you can feel really smart because you learned it in church. The image of God, the Imago Dei, he created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And then in verse 28, he gives them their marching orders. Okay, this is your purpose for existing. And God blessed them, and he said to them, be fruitful and multiply. And that's a rated PG version of doing what you think that means. Be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it. Okay, so be fruitful and multiply and then work. Get in there, subdue the earth, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the heavens and over every living thing that moves on the earth. In other words, work is not a bad thing. Work is a good thing. Work is not a result of the fall. Work is not a part of the curse. Work is going to exist in heaven. Work does not exist just because Adam and Eve sinned. Work existed before Adam and Eve sinned. Work is something that God loves, something that we as mankind were created to do. Work is a good thing. And God's saying, get out there and work. That's one of the reasons that I created you. And if you look a little further in that text in Genesis chapter 1, I think in verse 31, you notice that God created mankind on the sixth day of creation. Does anybody know what God did on the seventh day? You remember from Sunday school? Did you say rested? Yeah, you got it right. Nice recall. God rested on the seventh day. So I want you to kind of put those two things together. And just so you know, this is what the Bible says, Genesis 2, 2. On the seventh day, God finished his work that he had done, and he rested. He rested on the seventh day from all his work that he had done. So if God rested on the seventh day, what do you think mankind did on the seventh day? They rested, right? So here's the deal. You got mankind. They're created on the sixth day. God says, be fruitful and multiply. Here's your purpose for living. I want you to work. I want you to have dominion over the earth. Everything that lives and moves and breathes, you're going to be the master of it. You're going to take care of the earth. And they go to bed at night, wake up, ready to go to work. I know what I'm going to do. First thing I'm going to do, be fruitful and multiply. Then I'm going to have dominion over the sea. They wake up on the seventh day, ready to go to work. And God says, actually, guys, today we're going to rest. We're not going to do any work. On the seventh day is the day that we rest. And what that gives you, I believe, something I didn't see before, but if you think about it, you can see. You have a design here, right here in the book of Genesis, that when it comes to work, God's original template for human flourishing is that we always work from a place of rest, and we don't rest from a place of work. And you think about most of the times that you rest, it's usually because you've just flat worn yourself out. You just come home, you lay on the bed, and you fall asleep because you're mentally, physically, emotionally exhausted. I mean, they call it adrenal fatigue. You're just wiped. And the original design was that we are supposed to work, toil, have dominion, produce from a place of rest, and not to just rest from a place of work. That's what you see in the book.